is the most important affair in every affair of life. The basic aspect of life that we cannot underplay, that must be attended to, is the affair of salvation. Is the affair of salvation. Is the affair of salvation. What incorporates us into our political family is by part equal to that power. And salvation is something that is meant by which we are born to the family of God. God bless 16 was also loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have a master. That tells you one thing, that there is two provisions available. There's a provision to perish, and there's a provision to be saved. And the solution that they were out of it all is by you choosing rather than they perish, choosing to be saved. And what does God want to save us from? He wants to save us from sin. He wants to save us from condemnation of sin. He also wants to save us from the nightmares and the manipulation that the enemy brings our life. I've come to realize something. That the devil these days, having tried to put people into captivity again, he allows them to go into captivity of their own choice. As we bow to sin, to enter the captivity that the enemy has set. The devil did not tell the woman in the garden that I want you to be under authority. He simply asks her to disobey God. And I've also come to realize that sin is disobedience against God. Sin is the instrument of devil in our hands, but righteousness is the instrument of God in our hands. And brethren, all the time as we speak, righteousness opposes the nation, but sin is a reproach of it. In essence, not minding the kind of prayer you are praying, and not minding the kind of dream that God for your life, if there is no holiness in your life, the dream for your life, you will be a mere shadow. You will be a mere shadow. Ask why that it doesn't mean holy. Because he wants to make it to the very end. And brethren, if as a child you can find yourself on the path of righteousness, you can be sure you only be on the path of rightness in life. Righteousness ensures rightness in life. When you choose to be the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, you can be sure you always find yourself on the right side of life in the hands of the Almighty God. Now, sin separates. Righteousness also separates. Sin separates. Righteousness also separates. Isaiah 59 verse 2. Isaiah 59 verse 2. The Bible says, but your iniquities have made a separation between you and God. In the same way, righteousness made a separation between you and the devil. Righteousness makes a separation between you and the devil. So righteousness separates. Sin also separates. That means each time you find yourself living in sin, going from fornication to fornication, it is separating you from God. You observe one thing, that each time you sin, you feel a void in your heart. You feel a burden in your heart. You feel as if God is far away from you. But contrary to that, the fact is that sin pushes you far away from God. And when you are far from the light, then you are born into darkness. And darkness is synonymous with ability. There are several of us. You know the kind of family you come from. Demonic background, negatively influenced background. And if you check the root cause of it, it is shrouded around whatever can be called sin and iniquity. I'd like to pray for you tonight. Every captivity that sin has brought into your life, as you echo amen, and as you turn around genuinely tonight, the Lord will break it in the name of Jesus. Sin is the catalyst for more sin. That's why you find somebody who is a perpetual liar. Very soon you will begin to be able to steal. Because sin empowers you to cover up. So lying empowers you to cover up whatever you do. So you tell yourself that you can cover up. But when you see myself that there's something called white lie, there's something called green lie, but the lie is lie. And even though you call it a small sin, you call it a small sin does not make you small in the sight of God. It is sin in the sight of God. You know that the Bible says in the book of Revelations that on the last day, the man John in the Lord said he saw before the great white throne, both young and old, waiting to be judged. You cannot say you are too young to be judged by God. The moment you identify right from right, right from wrong, you are matured enough to pray for your mercy, Lord God. But I pray for you tonight. Every stubborn heart that wants to hinder you from turning back to God tonight, I ask that the power of the blood of Jesus will bring it in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I make a very profound issue, profound testimony. I was someone that I needed to minister last year. And there was a young lady in that particular congregation who had been deep in immorality, deep in fornication, deep in lesbianism, deep in... I can't begin to explain. And she was a teenager. Young. Probably less than 12 or 13 or so. And at that age, she had not come to 6 abortions. And the parent did not know at all. She was suffering, but she could not help herself. And at that meeting, she responded to the Lord of God. And that was when the solution. You cannot help yourself when sin is involved. Within God, the good of heaven. That is why when God saves you, He promotes you forward to begin to live a righteous life. And then holiness begins. But when I come to a vision that God was for, you have chosen to be holy. You have chosen. If you will, Bible says in that text that for He chose us in Him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in His sight. And then number two, we are called to be holy. We are called to be holy. We are called to be holy. 4 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 7. 4 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 7 says, for God did not call us to impurity, but to live a life of holiness. And then number three, we are called to worship the Holy One. You must perform as an instrument of worship and accept that only your worship is not accepted. Not minding how good your voice, not minding how wonderful your dance, if your life is not on the register of God's book of life, you are absent in the sight of God. For example, as we are here tonight, in sight of God, some of us are present and some of us are absent. It's when those who are absent yield to salvation that those who become present. I pray for you tonight. As many Muslims are reading the book of life, may it not be erased in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As many Muslims are not yet in the book of life, may they be enlisted tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Psalm 39 verse 2, Psalm 39 verse 2 says, ascribe to the Lord in glory into His name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of His holiness. And worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness. And 1 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 29. And as 16 verse 29 says, glory, say, give to the Lord the glory He deserves. Bring your offering and come into His presence. As you begin to pray, can I remind you that the vessel that will be called the vessel of God is a vessel that is pure, is a vessel that is saved, is a vessel that is living for you. 2 Timothy 2 verse number 21, that if a man therefore purge himself of these things, shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified and meet for the master's use. And that is why at the end of the day, when we get to the great white throne, and some say, Lord, in your name we cast out devils, in your name we heal the sick, you will say, I know you not. Why? Because they are not saved. And why? Because they are not living good. I'd like you to rise in your feet tonight. Please rise in your feet this very night. Please rise.